Crossfire. On the left, Tom Brayton. On the right, Robert Novak. In the Crossfire, Washington Times columnist John Lofton and rock musician Frank Zappa.
Good evening. Welcome to Crossfire. What you've got here is suggestive, and I don't find it objectionable. But when you actually listen to the words of the songs, you get a shock. Personally, I find some of them in such bad taste as to make me physically ill, and some of them I wouldn't have in the house. Now, on the other hand, do we want the government to ban the sale of records with lyrics the government doesn't like? Do we want the government to say this is okay, but this one will have to go? And who should be the government censor? Whose job should it be to listen all day to dirty records and decide whether you can? Do you want censorship of records as is now being proposed in Maryland and in congressional hearings, or do you want to make the decision on your own? Take it or leave it, all by yourself. Bob?
Mr. Zappa, let me see if I can get your position straight. Are you saying that there is no filth, no pornography, no obscenity that should not be permitted to be sold and distributed freely in this country in the form of music videos and rock music?
I don't think that music qualifies as pornography. And especially since this whole business started with words. We're talking about words here.
All right.
All the complaints were about words.
All right, take the pornography out there. Is there no filth, no obscenity that you think would qualify to be suppressed?
We're talking about words, and I don't believe that there is any word that needs to be suppressed. There's no scientific or realistic reason why you should keep people from hearing certain words.
Yeah, but they should even, let me just follow that up.
There are certain words you use that are to describe an act of fornication which are brutal.
So?
Well,
How about putting that on the radio? That's not permitted to be put on the radio. Do you think it should be?
Yes.
You think it should be on the radio?
Absolutely.
And on television?
Absolutely.
And
in politics.
I don't understand.
Because
that.
It's already in politics. I think that if you use the so-called strong words, you get your point across faster and you can save a lot of beating around the bush. Well, why are people afraid of words?
Well, look, Mr. Zappa, we're not talking about just words. When we talk about rock videos, we're not talking about rock videos. I beg your pardon, but
the whole thing is words.
I beg your pardon, but what they're trying to
they're selling it with rock
what
videos.
What they're trying to restrict in Maryland is also obscene rock videos.
No, they are not.
They're trying to apply the obscenity language to videos and to records. But why do you underestimate the power of words? Words have consequences. They have impact on people. Now, I agree with you that the first line of responsibility is the family to stop the kind of garbage that we're talking about here today. But good grief, can't we call on our government to help us in this fight, Frank? I mean, you have kids. Are you an anarchist? Is it the government's role to do nothing about this?
No, I'm a conservative, and you may not like that, but I am. And the fact of the matter is, this bill that they're talking about in Maryland is stupid.
How so? What is the function of government, Frank, the civil government? Isn't it to, in part, promote general welfare and to help protect families?
Do you think that you're protecting somebody by taking away seven words?
It's not just words.
It is words. It's about words.
Words also connote ideas, Mr. Zappa. Are you for songs that portray incest as just another kind of sex and perhaps even preferable sex? Are you for that?
Would you ban the mention of any incestual activities? Would you?
Well, why don't we make a pact?
Then why don't you better take a look at the Bible and see what's in there, what happens after Sodom and Gomorrah.
The Bible does not advocate incest.
But it
condemns it, Frank.
It mentions it.
We're talking about advocacy, Mr. Zappa.
No, we're not. We're talking about words.
No, we're not
talking about content of the words.
Oh, you don't think words connote ideas, huh?
Yes, they can be assembled into sentences and get ideas.
Well, how about answering my question about incest? Do you support records that promote incest as just another kind of sex, or in some instances it might even be preferable? Do you agree with that?
No, I don't agree with it. I have no interest in incest, but I don't think that anybody in his right mind would desire to have the government step in to make sure that they install a censor board that keeps certain things from being said.
Let me ask you something, Mr. Zappa.
Because sometimes the dumbest thing that gets said makes the point for you. And if a person is doing a song about incest, it gives you a chance to say, maybe incest is really wrong. I didn't realize that incest was such a terrible problem in the United States that we suddenly needed government intervention to cure incest in America by keeping words off of records.
Well, of course, incest in America didn't used to be such a terrible problem, did it, Mr. Zappa? That's come about in the last 20 years or so.
Oh, come on, God, not so.
Oh, really?
I understand your position on government censorship, but just you're a musician. you're a producer, you're a big man in show business. Do you think it is a good idea? Let's not say that the government's going to get in this all. Just as a matter of taste, of artistic preference, do you think it's a good idea to write lyrics that says incest is good for you? Does that make any sense?
Well, it might make sense to Prince. That's his business, because that's mainly the song that they're talking about.
Don't you have an opinion on it?
My opinion is he's got a right to sing it, he's got a right to say it,
really?
And I got a right
really?
To not buy it.
Where does that right come from, Mr. Zappa? Where does the right to advocate incest come from?
That song does not advocate incest.
No, there are songs that advocate incest.
Tell me them. I haven't heard.
It says incest.
Well, you ought to get out more. And I don't think you're being candid with it. You know what those signs are. Songs are. Now, you said there's a right to do this. Where does the right come from? Your group was called the Mothers of the Invention.
Mothers of Invention. You've got to get out more.
Yeah, and you're a very inventive guy. You make up a lot of stuff, like what was in the mind of the founding fathers. Would you look at the camera and tell them? Any camera.
And tell them. Directing the show?
Yeah, that's right. Well, you certainly need some direction, Mr. Zappa.
Want to spank me here? Come on, what are you talking
about? Well, you into that, too, huh? No, I'm not into spanking.
I love it when you froth like that.
I'm sure. Now, would you tell our viewers that what the founding fathers...
I thought he was going to be the one frothing today. I'm glad that you're doing it.
Wrong again, Frank. Wrong again.
Now, I've got a napkin for you.
Would you tell us? Excellent. Thank you very much. Now, would you look in the camera and tell him with a straight face that you think the founding fathers had in mind the kind of garbage you sing and write when they drafted the Fifth Amendment? Do you really believe that, Mr. Zappa?
I don't think it applies. The founding fathers, one thing, kept slaves. And take a look at what Benjamin Franklin used to do over at the Hellfire Club.
But you have repeatedly...
Not exactly
you have
a bunch of swell guys. I think they had some good things in mind. But we have a document, the letter of the law. Yeah. Let's use the letter of the law and interpret it based on the 20th
century. Wait a minute. It is relevant because you have repeatedly, in opposing even ratings for rock music, you have repeatedly cited the Constitution and the First Amendment. Do you think the founding fathers really had the First Amendment, that they gave us the First Amendment to defend songs that glorify Satanism and incest and suicide? You really believe
Absolutely.
That?
Absolutely.
You really believe
that?
Yeah,
I believe it.
Well, you're an idiot, then.
Mr. Tell you what, kiss my... How do you
take your teeth out. Take your teeth out and we'll talk.
Let's call it
off. Come on, let's get this serious here. Come on, let's...
Mr. Zappa, one thing you did I didn't think you'd do is you ducked a question. I thought you'd
ask. Which one?
I understand your position in the government. I understand you have an absolutist position on the First Amendment. A lot of people have an absolutist position. But I asked you a question and you ducked it. I want you to tell me if you think that the lyrics saying that incest is a good thing have any artistic value or are in good taste, or if you approve them. You must have some standards of your own. I'm not talking about the government.
You asked me for my opinion. I don't enjoy that kind of material. I'm not here to sell records for Prince or anybody else.
But you defend it being sold, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, then you're part of the problem.
Don't you think it would be a good thing to say to some of these people to cool it?
No, it's not my job.
What is your job?
My job is to represent myself.
What is your job? You once wrote a song called "We're All in It for the Money."
It's not a song. It's the name of an album.
Is that right?
You ought to get out more.
Yeah. How much money you made peddling this stuff, Mr. Zappa?
Millions of dollars.
Yeah.
Millions of dollars, Mr. Lofton.
All right, look, it seems to me, Mr. Zappa, that you've got to ask these people, both of them are on you,
He's accusing me of doing something that is similar to what that is being argued about. My lyrics aren't in question here.
Really?
They're not.
What would you propose, Mr. Lofton, as the means of censorship?
Well, I said I agree with Mr. Zappa that the first line of defense and responsibility is the parents. But what I do not agree with is that the parents have to stand alone, and we are not entitled to call upon our government to help us in the fight against
this kind of filth. What government censure is going to decide for you?
It's not... Tom, I've heard you say repeatedly on this show that we are our government, that we're allowed to call on our government.
Well, you have to have a man who is the censor or a woman.
They have
to decide this
Tom.
Lofton can hear and this
That's
Lofton
right.
cannot hear.
Tom, it would work the way the implementation of any law works. You pass a law, it has words in it, and then the elected representatives of the people try their best to apply it. It's the way you do it with everything else. Will they apply it perfectly? No. But we're entitled to use the force of our civil government to help protect our families. How could you oppose that? Does the government have any purpose, Frank?
Yeah, it has
what?
A number of purposes.
What is it? Name
I'm
one.
Not going to give you a civics lesson here, but I'll tell you one thing. We must not see eye to eye on the idea of a government that must forbid things in order to
really?
Protect
Really? What is
families?
The government's role? You've told me several times what it shouldn't do.
How about national defense?
Yeah, I consider this national defense, pal. Our families are under attack from people like you with these lyrics.
John, you don't have to buy them.
Mr. Zappa,
could I make a statement about national defense?
Yeah.
The biggest threat to America today is not communism. It's moving America toward a fascist theocracy. And everything that's happened during the Reagan administration is steering us right down that pipe.
Oh, Mr. Zappa, do you really think? All kidding aside, in this country, with the progressiveness that we are moving toward a fascist theocracy, anything goes.
You bet we are, buddy.
Do you think things like this would have ever been permitted?
Give me that famous smile again.
When we were kids, you're about my age, maybe
I'm
a little 45.
Younger.
Well, I'm 55. Do you think when I was a kid that they would permit songs like that to be sold? I mean, permissiveness is the game. You're not really serious if you're saying we're going toward a fascist theocracy.
That's right, we are.
Wait a minute.
In what way? Give me one example.
One example of a fascist theocracy.
When you have a government that prefers a certain moral code mm-hmm. derived from a certain religion, and that moral code turns into legislation to suit one certain religious point of view, and if that code right. happens to be very, very right-wing, almost toward Attila the Hun...
Well, then you are an anarchist. Every form of civil government is based on some kind of morality, Frank.
Morality in terms of behavior, not
well, of
in terms of theology.
Well, of course, but look, I mean... I couldn't believe in your hearing.
Wait a minute, gentlemen. We have to take a break now.
Okay. We're gonna come
and
back.
We'll be back with John Lofton and Frank Zappa talking about rock music, I think, after these messages.
Producer and musician who has testified before Congress that he does not think that rock music, dirty lyrics and all, should be censored.
Or rated.
John Lofton takes the other view. Mr. Lofton.
Yes.
You don't have to buy this, you know. You don't have to buy this music with dirty words.
Well, I guess my concern extends beyond my own family, beyond my own children. I'm concerned about the whole society. The whole country, other people's families.
Can you control what your children
like? Not completely, but I try. I agree, and I want to say for the third time, I agree with Frank that is the first line of responsibility.
But you can't even control what your children.
No, as they get older, it's very difficult.
No, but you can control what they listen to in the house and the rap.
Tell me how you.
They're rarely in the house.
You hear it, so
Shut the up in the room, and you can't hear it.
I hear it. I turn it. I go up and I. Throw the record
you can't
away.
You hear half the things I tell you. You can't hear those things.
All you're trying to get around is the fact that you have an individual responsibility, and I think Mr. Zappa is right. That's as far as it can go.
Well, but you know, one of the things that interests me is the seemingly totally different worlds that you and I live in, Mr. Zappa. For example, you told this hearing last September that in America, quote, there is a tendency to hide sex, unquote. That is the most ridiculous statement I've ever heard. Sex is everywhere in America. It's on TV, radio, videos, advertising. What do you mean we hide sex in America?
You do hide sex in America because if given the choice between putting erotic sex mm-hmm. into a television show or putting violence, usually it is the violence that is opted
How
for.
How about both?
Putting both in?
Yeah.
Or you mean in combination?
Well, I mean both. I mean the television is full of sex right now.
It's not really sex. It's full of titillation.
How about advertising? Is that full of sex?
It's titillation.
Mr. Zappa, when somebody mentioned the videos, you said, hey, no, this is not it. Why don't you want to talk about the videos?
The reason I don't want to talk about the videos is the issue came up over the lyrics and what they have done in trying to promote the issue. If rock videos did not exist, they wouldn't have had those flashy little bumpers to put on before each of the local news shows when they would do a story on this.
Do you feel differently about rock videos then, that they should be censored?
No, I don't. I just think that you shouldn't even discuss them when the topic is words.
But I mean, we can discuss anything we want.
Oh, sure.
But you think anything goes on the rock videos just like anything goes on the lyrics?
Sure.
I'm told that there is a rock video that it's about to come out that has a school teacher undressing in front of a student.
It's out already. It's one of the ones they use for bumpers. They showed it at the Senate hearing. It's called Hot for Teacher, and the group is Van Halen.
What do you think of that?
I think it's amusing.
amusing that...
Why do you think the kids should
because... Well, tell me what it's about a little bit. He thinks it's amusing that you might have a grade school class that is hot for teacher in a sexual way. Why is that amusing?
Why shouldn't it be amusing?
Well, you're not smiling. You don't look too happy about the
Well, why should I smile sitting here with you?
Well, you can fake it, right?
I like him better than you.
What is
your rough idea of what's going on
here? It sure does. Uh-huh. But, of course, I had that before I came here. Uh-huh. What's amusing about it?
That is amusing to the people who like the concept of here comes the teacher. Mm. You expect the teacher to be sour. The music starts. The teacher takes off her clothes, and she is wearing some kind of a bathing suit like in a beauty contest and does a dance on the desk, and the kids look up, and they are having a good time.
Well, that's a real laugh riot, Frank. Mm. Now, look, one of the things I don't understand is someone who writes why you have repeatedly denigrated words and said, well, something's just words. You know, Adolf Hitler used words very effectively. It was called the big lie, and what it resulted in was 6 million Jews being put into ovens. Now, why do you say that words aren't important and don't have consequences?
I didn't say the words weren't important.
What do you mean when you say just words?
This argument basically is about the 7 dirty words that the FCC complains about. And that's what it is. And I don't see any reason to keep people from hearing those syllables put together. Right. Those are not magic words. That's not abracadabra. You're going to turn into something.
Do they have an impact,
you think? Certainly they do. And it depends on how they're used and in what context. In fact, the big one, the one that starts with the F, has maybe 15 different ways in which it can be used in language.
Mr. Zappa, you were talking about the social background of the Founding Fathers, so you're a student of American sociology. But let me ask you this. Do you think this country, you get around this country a lot, I'm sure, do you think that the lyrics of these songs reflect the real spirit of this country?
It reflects certain aspects of the spirit of this country.
You think it does?
If you don't like the spirit, then change the things that make the spirit happen. In other words, if you have kids that are rebellious, and you have kids who are hopeless, you have kids who go to drugs, then give them something to hope for.
Like what? What would you tell a kid he ought to hope for nowadays, Frank?
What I tell kids, and I've been telling kids for quite some time, is first, register to vote, and second, as soon as you're old enough, run for something.
And you really think that's going to give kids hope to tell them to go register for vote?
Mr. Zappa, when you...
Well, I don't know whether it makes them commit suicide, but I think it gives them a little bit more hope.
Mr. Zappa, testifying in Annapolis yesterday, I think, or this week, at any rate, they had some kids from New York picketing outside who were from a school for the mentally disturbed, and they said that the rock music almost ruined their life. Rock music really disturbed them. Didn't that give you some pause as to maybe you were making, if you might be an error on this question?
Well, see, you're an error as to where those kids came from. It's not a school for the mentally disturbed. It is a place called Freedom Village run by a man named Pastor Fletcher A. Brothers, a Christian organization. He collects money for it. They have a farm in upstate New York. I've dated Pastor Brothers on the radio before. I've also seen his literature. Basically, what he has done is taken the children who have come to his place for rehabilitation. I don't know where he gets them, who sends them, but he carts them around the country in the Freedom Village bus and makes them go in and testify as to all the bad things that happened to them before they came to his place, and then he connects it to rock music. Let me tell you some of the things that are included in this man's literature. He sends out this folder, it's about this thick, that has a list of different people in rock and roll, their names, their records, and their crime against humanity, so to speak. Some of the people who are included in this list are Stevie Wonder, and his crime is that he has an album that mentions astrology. In his folder, there are 2 or 3 mentions of astrology and maybe 3 or 4 mentions of Hinduism. He cites The Who because they had a Hindu prayer on one of their albums. And I question him on the air.
Let me ask you about something you said. I want to talk now. You've talked for a little while, okay? I think your answer about where hope is supposed to lie shows the bankruptcy of what once used to be the radical message. We have millions of kids in this country, Frank, who may be suicidal, who see no meaning in life, see no hope in life, and you're going to tell them that the hope is in registering to vote, Frank? Are you serious?
Are you trying to dissuade them from registering to vote? Are you trying to dissuade those kids from running for office? Is that what you're doing?
I mean, we're talking about kids that don't know the meaning of life, Frank, and you tell them to vote?
We are out of time. We want to thank Mr. Zappa for being our guest on Crossfire, and John Lofton for being our guest on Crossfire. Bob and I will be back in just a minute. I take it you don't like the records any more than I do, but who's to be the censor? Should you be?
Well, I don't know about that either. I'm a First Amendment man, but I'll tell you what I do know, Tom, and I think you'll agree with me. The idea that parents are going to tell their kids what they can and what they can't hear in this day and age is ridiculous. I mean, they're no more able to censor their kids than the government is, than you want the government to censor everybody else.
No, some of them will get the records, but I just don't think it's possible to draw the line for somebody to sit
I'll
and
tell
say, Stevie Wonder is all right and this guy's got to go.
I tell you where the censorship should come from. It should come from the industry, and they should have a little more self-policing and a little more self-control, in my opinion.
I think that's a good idea. From the left, I'm Tom Braden. Good night for Crossfire.
From the right, I'm Robert Novak. Join us again next time for another edition of Crossfire.
If you would like to comment on tonight's program, write to CNN Crossfire, 111 Massachusetts Avenue Northwest, Washington, D.C., 20001.